It doesn't matter where you go in life, as long as you can go to the beach, the popular saying goes. And frankly, it's true. Not only can it be a great time with friends and family, bonding with Mother Nature, soaking up the sun and surf, with sunscreen, of course. If you keep your eyes peeled and watch your step, you can discover the most strange and unusual, and sometimes extremely valuable things washed up on the shore. But be warned, sometimes these mysterious treasures can be dangerous too. Here are the 15 strangest things washed up on beaches.
Civil War era cannonballs found just sitting on the beach. People walking along the beach found them, called authorities.
Don't forget to smash the like button, subscribe to The Supreme, and click the notification bell for more lit content. Let's get rolling. Number 15, barnacle-encrusted turtles. Check out this strange photograph by David Fenwick in 2019. A staggering 22 young turtles, several encrusted with barnacles, indicating severe malnourishment, became stranded along the Florida coastline, pushing local wildlife organizations to their limits. They were nursed back to life thanks to a team of dedicated experts at the Turtle Hospital in Marathon, Florida. Scientists aren't sure why the turtles were beached or why they became critically malnourished, but green sea turtles stranded on Central Florida Atlantic Ocean beaches had been a normal springtime occurrence for the past couple of years. But the good news is the shell chemistry of the barnacles may enable scientists to determine the migratory origin of endangered loggerhead turtles, because barnacles are filter feeders. They all eat the same things in the same places, so their chemical composition will more accurately reflect where they've been in the ocean compared with the turtles. Number 14, demon dolphin of Sakhalin. Usually, when a sea creature washes ashore, it's a whale or a turtle, not a mystery beast with a fur tail and large beak. The remains of a mystery sea animal were recently discovered washed up on Sakhalin Island in Russia. The enigmatic remains of a giant marine animal with a furry tail found in Russia's Far East have puzzled locals and social media. The remains featured a furry tail and huge nose, making it very difficult to identify the creature. Scientists explained, "We have gathered a group of scientists, we studied all the versions, and came to the conclusion that the fossils found ashore belonged to a whale cub," said Nicole Kim from the local Research Institute of Fisheries and Oceanography. "The cub must have been a giant beaked whale, a species that is quite common for the region, so the discovery is no wonder. Besides, all dolphins and whales are born with hairs that coat the body and disappears with age. Giant bottlenose whales are the largest of all beaked whales, reaching up to 40 feet in length and found in the North Pacific. Number 13, pickle invaders. In the spring of 2017, hordes of bizarre sea creatures began swarming the coast of Oregon. They had bumpy, tubular bodies, gelatinous skin, and they emitted a strong glow. Sometimes called sea pickles, these creatures are more accurately known as pyrosomes. Millions of these things were clogging up the West Coast, ripping apart fishing nets, getting caught on fishing hooks, and washing up onto the beach. They had invaded the waters of British Columbia and been spotted as far north as Sitka, Alaska. During a cruise to study the critters, one team of researchers scooped up 60,000 pyrosomes in 5 minutes. Typically, they're found in warm waters like the Ivory Coast or the Mediterranean Sea, where some species can grow up to 60 feet long and are wide enough for a person to fit inside. Marine biologists rarely get a chance to observe them since they tend to stay far below the surface of the ocean, away from the shore, and still are not sure why pyrosomes proliferated to such extremes along the Pacific coast. Number 12, the capelin fish roe. These silverfish are capelin. They come to Newfoundland and Labrador on the east coast of Canada every year to spawn, and their arrival is a spectacle that draws in thousands of birds and whales who often put on a show of their own. People love the annual capelin roe too. It's an event that's unusual and it's unpredictable. And though the exact date is difficult to predict, it typically happens mid-June or July. The fish roe marks the beginning of summer weather, along with a chance to spy humpback whales coming to feed on these slender, speedy fish. And they're also a traditional delicacy, high in fat and rich in energy, very nutritious. So seals, whales, seabirds, and other bigger fish just love to join in on the rolling frenzy. Shimmering pale green and silver, capelin look like anchovies or sardines or smelts. At a glance, they grow to a length of up to 8 inches. Interesting fact, males can be distinguished by the ridges they develop down their bodies. This helps them stick by their mates during spawning. Number 11. The Rochness Monster. This terrifying mystery creature found washed up on the banks of a lake could be an unknown ancient species from the murky depths. The corpse of the creature was discovered at Hollingworth Lake in Rochdale, Greater Manchester in England. Eyewitnesses spotted the 5-foot creature at the edge of the water. Its clever nickname? The Rochness Monster, like Scotland's fabled Loch Ness Monster, is thought to be a very large and very scary looking dead pikefish. But others are not convinced and have vowed to steer clear of the lake. Famously aggressive, the predator can grow up to 6 feet in length and weigh over 50 pounds. While normally feeding on smaller fish species, pikes are even known to turn on each other when food is scarce. And they have hundreds of pin-like teeth, which are extremely efficient at ripping into its prey. And since pikes are regularly found in the 130-acre Rochdale Reservoir, it makes sense that this strange corpse made its way to the lakeshore. Number 10. The Cannibal Rat Ship. In 2014, there were reports that the abandoned former Soviet cruise line Lubov or Lova was caught in the Irish coast, bringing with it ominous headlines warning of cannibal rats aboard a ghost ship heading our way. Oh, heck no. Just imagine it. A shadowy vessel silently docking in the dark of night while cat-sized killer pirate rodents descend and scurry across our city, brandishing their fangs ready to gnaw at our bones. Nightmare. The 4,200-ton ship was once the glittering choice of Soviet holidaymakers and later wealthy Russians touring the Arctic and Antarctic. And before it washed ashore, the Lyubov or Lova was seen adrift off the coast of Newfoundland earlier in 2013. The ship had been sold for scrap and was headed for the Dominican Republic. But less than a day into the journey, the tow line broke and the ship drifted into international waters. Those searching for the ship said there were likely to be thousands of disease-ridden rats on board with no source of food except each other. The 4,250-ton ship was built to carry 110 passengers but was impounded in Canada in 2010 after being deserted by her crew in a debt dispute. Number 9. The Mysterious Giant Eyeball. A beachcomber found the softball-sized eyeball on the sand in Pompano Beach, Florida on Wednesday, speculating that perhaps it came from a squid. But experts who examined the grapefruit-sized eyeball came to the conclusion it was, in fact, a swordfish based on its size, color, and structure. The big blue eyeball found on the beach was cut out of a swordfish hauled in by a deep-sea angler, according to the State Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission. Swordfish, which can reach up to 1,100 pounds, are common in South Florida, so it makes sense. Speaking of swordfish eyeballs, these animals have special organs right next to their eyes for warming both their eyes and their brains. The ability to heat their eyes improves the quality of their vision, therefore it also increases their ability to hunt. Know what else? Swordfish are one of the fastest and most powerful fish in the ocean. When someone actually hooks one of these sportfish, they've been known to dive so fast and so furiously that they run their swords into the ocean ground. Ouch. But with eyes that big, didn't they see that coming? Number 8. Great White Shark Murder Mystery. Great white sharks have washed up dead on a beach believed to be the latest victim of killer whales off the coast of South Africa, with vital organs missing. Say what? The sharks were washed up dead within days of each other on a popular tourist beach, all uneaten, but with their livers missing. The first of three dead great white sharks that washed ashore was a 16-foot-long female that weighed more than 2,400 pounds. Scientists say the four great whites had their livers removed with surgical precision, prompting claims that the pods of orcas in the area, south of Cape Town, are to blame. Soon after, a fourth dead liverless shark washed ashore. The newly discovered 13-foot-long male great white was missing its liver, testes, and stomach, according to a local blog post. This shark was found in a town on the South African coast on May 3, 2017. But great white sharks are notoriously shy of the top shelf predator. Orcas are highly organized and efficient when hunting in teams. When confronted by orcas, white sharks will immediately vacate their preferred hunting ground and will not return for up to a year, even though the orcas are only passing through. Number 7. Siberian snowballs. A strange and beautiful sight greeted locals in the Gulf of Ob in northwest Siberia after thousands of natural snowballs formed on the beach. An 11-mile stretch of coast was covered in the icy spheres. The sculptural shapes range from the size of a tennis ball to almost 3 feet across. Videos and photos from the Gulf of Ob showed the beach covered in snowballs that had apparently washed ashore. They result from a rare environmental process where a small piece of ice forms, then is rolled by wind and water, and end up as giant snowballs. A similar phenomenon has occurred along Lake Michigan in America, where boulder-sized ice balls can form in winter months. When chunks of the ice sheets that cover parts of the lake in winter break off, they churn in the waves and become ice spheres. These naturally occurring snowballs can invade during winter months when, in the right conditions, a combination of light, sticky snow, strong winds, and cold temperatures create these strange super snowballs. Number 6. The Somerton Man. One of Australia's most baffling cold cases could be a step closer to being solved after more than 7 decades of mystery. It's been almost 71 years since 2 trainee jockeys came across the body of a fully clothed man lying near the shore of Somerton Park Beach in 1948. He was hunched against the seawall at the top of the beach, wearing a suit and shoes and an unlit cigarette resting on his chest. The suit he was wearing, which included a double-breasted jacket, was perfectly pressed. All the tags on every piece of clothing had also been removed and his shoes perfectly polished. The notorious cold case came to be known as the Tamam Shud case because of a phrase scribbled on a piece of paper hidden in the man's jacket. Tamam Shud is a Persian phrase which means finished or ended, which he was, and his purpose for being in the area remained a mystery until recently when officials allowed the man's body to be exhumed. Approval was granted for his body to be dug up and examined in the hope that new technology might provide the answers needed to crack the case. Turns out, he died from being poisoned, and the man known only as the Somerton Man was never identified. Number 5. La Push Beach Driftwood. More than 200 feet long and 13 feet across the trunk, this is one piece of wood that nobody will be using to play fetch on any beach with their dog. The giant western red cedar was one of dozens of trees washed up at La Push, a small community in Washington state on the U.S. West Coast. The tree is thought to have been carried into the Pacific Ocean from the Olympic National Park on the northwest corner of the state near the Canadian border. The coastline of the park, which is 1 million acres in size, is covered with the western red cedar. Douglas fir and Sitka spruce are also signature trees common in the area. The mountain slopes of the temperate rainforest that cover the area rise quickly away from the La Push coast. When a strange gale blows through the community, it can topple trees. Park officials believe a combination of a strong gale and high tide had brought the trees ashore. Number 4. The Montauk Monster. When a strange, decaying animal washed up onto Montauk Shore in Long Island in July 2008, the rumors began. After newspapers first ran pictures of the dead animal and posted them online, interest in the creature, dubbed the Montauk Monster, was everywhere. The bloated carcass wasn't in perfect shape. It was missing some teeth, had long legs, and appeared to be skinned. It also had quickly turned to bones. Upon closer look at the photos, the animal appeared to be a raccoon. Darren Nash wrote a pretty convincing argument that the monster is, in fact, a raccoon, saying, "It was the digits of the hand that gave this away from me. The Montauk carcass has a very strange, elongated, almost human-like fingers with short claws. Raccoons are well known for having particularly dexterous fingers that lack the sort of interdigital webbing normally present in carnivorans." If you're surprised by the length of the Montauk animal's limbs, note that raccoons are actually surprisingly leggy. Good to know. Would you like a closer look? Number 3. Jellyfish invasion. Hundreds of jellyfish washed up on a popular beach in North Devon, a municipality in England. The jellies were spotted on Woolacombe Beach by a resident, Richard Walden. It's understood that this particular breed are moon jellyfish, which are largely harmless. They're common species around most continents on Earth. They can survive in both warm and cooler waters and have large populations in Canada and Europe. Their numbers have actually been on the rise in recent years, partly because overfishing has eliminated many of their natural enemies. While there are more than 200 species of jellyfish, just 6 of them are routinely found in the UK waters, but all of them can sting. The impact of the sting will vary from species to species and person to person, and you can be stung whether the jellyfish is dead or alive, and whether it's in the water or on land. Fortunately, nobody was hurt during the invasion of the jellyfish. Number 2. Civil War Cannonballs. Beachgoers found 2 Civil War-era cannonballs on the edge of Folly Beach in South Carolina, uncovered by Hurricane Dorian and just laying in the sand. Hurricane Dorian was an extremely powerful and devastating Category 5 Atlantic hurricane. After it was reported, local police and fire squads responded, confirming the relics and making sure the cannonballs weren't still live and dangerous. Aaron Latin and his girlfriend found the cannonballs off East Ashley Avenue on the beach, overlooking the Morris Island Lighthouse. Explaining to the local press, "I wanted to get a metal detector, and especially after the hurricane, and see if there's anything, any history or artifacts that kind of washed up on the shore," Latin said. "We actually just got lucky with no equipment, just spending a day at the beach. But still very dangerous. Centuries-old cannonballs still pose a significant safety threat. Some are simply large steel projectiles, but others are live explosives liable to detonate if handled. In 2008, for example, hobbyist Sam White, 53, was restoring a 75-pound cannonball when it exploded, killing him and sending shrapnel flying into his neighbor's porch. Number 1. Priceless Whale Vomit. A Thai fisherman got stinking rich after spotting a vast lump of floating gold worth $330,000. Jumris Thaikat discovered a 14-pound piece of ambergris while he was walking along the beach in southern Thailand. The fisherman, unsure of what it was, kept it in his shed and carried it. If you don't know what ambergris is, well, it's a rare substance that's been highly valued for thousands of years as an ingredient in perfume and pharmaceuticals. It originates in the intestines of male sperm whales, and eventually the animal cast out a huge lump of the whale vomit, except it doesn't come out of its mouth, and up to hundreds of pounds at a time. Officials from the local Thai government finally visited the fisherman and confirmed the waxy lump was genuine ambergris. Just don't call it whale vomit. This is a highly prized natural treasure, used by past kings and still sought after by perfumers and scientists worldwide. In another instance, a lump of this stuff found on a beach in Wales was sold to a French buyer for $15,000 at an auction in England back in 2015. That was the 15 strangest things washed up on beaches. Thanks for watching.